Hey folks, hope you're doing good today. Hope you had a good weekend and a good week. Man, it's been a quick one on the channel, but I think we've had some super amazing bands on this week. Monday and Tuesday's videos are some of the best videos I've put out on this channel. Super amazing, ridiculous, heavy, extreme grindcore on Monday. And then because we had some blackness in that video as well, really wanted to hear more black metal bands. And the three bands I put on Tuesday were not only some of the best black metal that you can hear, period, but some of the best music that you can hear, period. And even if you're not into black metal and you thought, well, I'm not really into that stuff, so I'll skip over that video, I'd say just go and check out 5 or 10 minutes of it, because the music in there just blew me away. Some absolute perfection in there as far as I'm concerned. And then we've had some cool stuff on since then as well. Some horror punk. The guys yesterday were super chunky and thick and had a great groove and attitude to their music. Really just got straight on board with that band. Loved it. And then today we're going to finish off the week with our new friend who's got on board with the channel. Loves being on the channel. And he says to me here, every track I release from here until forever, which is going to be a long time, I'm going to be hitting up your channel, haha, thank you, which is super dope. I love to hear that. Now, whether he does that or not doesn't matter, because he said he's going to do it, which is good enough for me. But man, when people get on board with this channel like that and they just really kind of want to hear me talk about their music, but not only that, kind of show other people in the community the music as well, maybe get tips from them, and just let us see you grow as a musician, as a one-man band, doing all the tasks that you need to do for that kind of stuff. I'll go on about it loads and loads, and in the last video I went on about it loads and loads, so I'm not going to do that today. But I really like getting on board with people who've still, you know, at the start of their journey, still got a ways to go, and we can see them get better and evolve. There's probably at least 10 bands that we're going to be doing that with now who are on board with this channel, and I just absolutely love it. Very, very cool. So the latest one he's got for us to check out with a lyric video is called The Plague. This is a one-man band, remember. He's done it all himself. Let's give it a spin. Nice grindy bass in there, caught my ear. Cool riffing. Yeah, he's nice on the guitar. Sounds great with the harmony. nice on the guitar. Can you hear that bass in the mix nicely? It's got a good grizzle and grind to it. Very cool. Yeah. Great metallic, just a heavy metal vibe to this one. Great guitaring. It's obviously a mostly guitaring one-man band, but he's absolutely killing it on the guitar. Great runs, great melody, great harmony stuff as well. Twiddly widdly, just with a good energy to it and stuff as well. I thought the guitar was really, you know, top level, good stuff. What I was thinking as well is this guy's lucky. He's got the right throat and the right tone to go with this kind of music, which isn't always the case when you're a one-man band, you know. You can't really, the tone of your throat is the tone of your throat. You can affect it somewhat, but you know, it's the shape of your throat and how wide it is and all the rest of it that creates your certain tone. That's why your voice sounds the way it does as well. And this guy's lucky that his tone suits the kind of music, because quite often, or sometimes at least, it happens where the tone that you've got as a singer doesn't necessarily suit the style of music you're trying to do. Maybe you're great at gutturals and you're trying to do some higher pitched thrashy stuff, and it's just not going to work out. But this guy's lucky, his voice suits the music that he's trying to play as well, and the stuff that he's good at, because he's obviously good at riffy, metallic, metalcore-y type stuff. And that tone that he's got with his voice goes with riffy, metallic, metalcore type stuff. Now, there's a couple of tips and tricks that I'd like to mention to him. I'm not quite sure if this guy is doing his own mixes at this stage. If I remember correctly, I think the last track that he did, he had sent it off to someone. He recorded all the parts and then sent it off. But if he is doing his own mixing, or even if he's using someone else, what I would say to him, and what I would say then to mention onto the mixer, if that's the case, is it would be nice to do a bit of double layering on the vocals. So just record it twice, try and make each performance sound very much like the initial performance, but the subtle differences and nuances in your two performances will create a thickness and a depth, and I think the vocal could just be a little bit thicker, bring in that kind of, you know, just a thickness sound to the vocal, like you do with the guitars when you pan them out to the left and right, but you just layer those straight on top of each other. I think that would bring a nice thickness to the vocal, that would just beef it up a bit more, because I think at this stage you've got all the riffs there. It was a great composition for this kind of music as well, all flowed in the right way and moved in the right way. But what I think you could do now to kind of make your sound just sound heavier and beefier and kind of a bit more professional in that way as well, is just crank it up, you know, do the things that you need to do, layer up the guitars, layer up the vocals. I think the drum, particularly the snare, could use a bit more reverb on there. It was a little bit dry. And these are all just little kind of small tweaks that you make to a final mix to kind of, you know, buff it up, polish it up, and just take it to that 10th level, so it sounds right, sounds proper. So I think all the elements are there for this kind of music, and if he wants to just get a tip from me on how to, you know, keep heading in the right direction with it, I would say just thicken it up, beef it up, and all that is really doing is just recording more layers, and getting a nice tight performance, and then the very slight subtle differences between the performances make it thick, make it it chunky, bring in a layering effect to the sound, and it sounds very good, and I think it would suit this kind of music. And next time we hear him, it'd be really kind of punchy and chunky, like the band we had on yesterday. If you want to get a tip of how to sound, of how I think this music could sound, check out yesterday's band, because they were thick, chunky, and the guitar tone was right. We could hear the bass in the mix as well. Even though the guitars had a super thick chunk to them, which would normally dominate a mix, they still managed to get the bass to cut through nicely. Now, we could hear the bass nicely in this one as well. It did have its own tone and cut through the guitars. But once you've layered up those guitars and layered up the vocals and stuff, is the bass still going to cut through? Maybe you need to do some layering and stuff on that as well. Because all you're just doing is beefing it up from here on out. You know, you've got the foundations, you just need to kind of whack more on top to make it big and chunky, because that's what this music requires. And I say, if you check out yesterday's band, I think they nailed the sound, they nailed the energy, and I was just on board with them absolutely straight away, because the music hits you. You know, it's like thick as treacle, and it just absolutely hits you like a ton of bricks. So yeah, that's what I want to hear from this guy going forward. No doubt he's going to get there. And as I say, we got now until forever that he's going to keep sending in the videos anyway. So get yourself comfy. We'll be checking this guy out a lot more in the future. I'm happy to do it. I'm on board with this guy already now. And I really like, as I say at the start of the video, getting on board with bands where we can see them evolve. We can see them get better. We can give them a couple of little tips on the way, just to make sure they're still heading in the right direction, or something they might not have thought about, or something like that. And I think that's why this guy's making submissions as well, so I can mention those things to him. So no doubt next time when the video comes through, the vocal will be double layered, the guitars be super thick and chunky, we can still hear the bass in the mix, and snare will have a bit more reverb on it, and it'll punch through the mix, and I'll have already run out of things to mention to him to keep getting better, and I'll just say, yeah, keep going. So there you go. Hope you've enjoyed that today. We've had a wicked week on the channel. If you've missed any of the videos this week, and you've got any spare time, you don't know what to do, just go back and check those videos out, because the bands this week have kicked ass. I've been buzzing after checking out the videos. So there you go. We'll be back tomorrow with the Monday grind again. But man, if it's anything like last week's video, it'd be an absolute killer one again. I'll have to, you know, keeping up in the quality for that stuff. Absolutely dope. So we'll see you around, guys. Cheers. Bye.